Good Tuesday. It is May 22nd. Here we are on the cusp of yet another hurricane season. We're 9 days out, but we already could possibly have our first system of the year. In fact, we have our first invest of the year. We're going to talk a little bit about what exactly that means and if it does have a possibility of getting the first name of the season, the 2018 season, which would be Alberto. Starting you off with satellite imagery. As you can see in the southwest Caribbean off the Yucatan Peninsula, we do have an area of very disturbed weather. And looking at it on satellite imagery, it does look quite impressive, especially the easternmost flank, which has the majority of the convection or the thunderstorm activity. That's a little bit of a problem because when we look for tropical systems, we need symmetry. The actual center of the storm is well situated to the west of all of the convection. We would need it to be wrapping all around the center there, have a closed center of circulation before it could be upgraded to the possibility of a tropical depression or tropical storm. At that point, it either gets a number or a name. And of course, that would be Alberto, or if it was a tropical depression, it'd be tropical depression number one. So this is where it's situated currently. It is moving very, very slowly, and it has some of the ingredients needed to kind of be conducive to it growing further and organizing. So as I mentioned, we aren't exactly in hurricane season yet. That begins on June 1st, lasts through November 30th, and that's when we find 97% of all named tropical systems. There is that 3% that happens out of season, and more recently, we've had a few in May. In fact, we go back since 2000, and there has been 8 storms that have had names. There's been 1 that's been a hurricane and 7 that have been tropical storms. You notice where the majority of them originate and kind of spend most of their lifetimes, off the southeast coast. So it's a little bit unusual that we're finding the current system down in the southwest parts of the Caribbean. Most recently, in 2016, we had a tropical storm, Bonnie, that actually made a landfall in South Carolina. And in 2007, we had Category 1 Andrea. In fact, I believe that Andrea is the one that made landfall there. Bonnie kind of zipped out to sea along the coastline there. So it's not out of the realm of possibility because it's happened before, but it is a little more rare. Again, that 3% happening out of season outside of the 97% that do. So we have 21 names now for the 2018 hurricane season, the first of which is going to be Alberto. Whether this storm that we're watching now gets that name or not, it'll eventually be used as we get into the season beginning on June 1st. Now, as we go through the hurricane season, you're going to hear a lot of different names here. I like to call this the tropical vocabulary pyramid because it increases in intensity as you get higher up the chain. Of course, topping out at a hurricane, starting off with a tropical wave. And right now, we're watching an investigative area, or like we call an invest. And eventually, it has a number and a letter after it as well. From there, it'll get a number as a tropical depression, then a name at tropical storm when it has winds over 39 miles per hour. And once it gets strong enough that the winds are sustained at 74 miles per hour or greater, it becomes a hurricane. And of course, from there, it goes up in categories, category 1 to category 5. We saw numerous of those last season. So what is an invest? Again, that's short for investigation. And normally that's followed by either an L or an E, depending on which basin we're talking about. Since we're talking about the Atlantic basin, we're following it with an L and then a number between 90 and 99. That's just to catalog it. Once it goes through those 9 numbers, it cycles back to 90. So right now we're watching invest 90L. In the Atlantic basin and the first of the season, so it's starting at 90. All right, you need a lot of ingredients for tropical development. First is warm water, over 80 degrees Fahrenheit or 26.5 degrees Celsius. As you can see from this map, that is there. 84-degree water temperatures in the southwestern parts of the Caribbean and moving up into the Gulf of Mexico, very, very warm. In fact, the anomalies are 1 to 2 degrees above average for this time of the year. So extremely warm, almost like bathwater there, and plenty of fuel available for this storm to develop. A really cool filter on here that we have for this season is any color that you're seeing on here that's orange or brighter indicates waters that are warm enough, 80 degrees or warmer. So you can see widespread across the area that we're watching off the Yucatan Peninsula right now. Another look at the satellite imagery. Notice the convection offset from the storm center right now. Not really conducive for it to grow. As it moves northwards, there is the possibility that it interacts with the Yucatan Peninsula itself. And of course, that's a whole nother problem. We don't like land interaction when we see a tropical system developing. That cuts off the moisture flow from the ocean or the energy flow. and effectively kills it. So if it does happen, we're going to have to wait until it gets into this area here, which is where it's forecast to track within the next 5 days. The latest update from the National Hurricane Center puts the possibility of this organizing itself into a named tropical system is about 40% within the next 5 days. Of course, the waters here, very, very warm still, as it lifts northwards very, very slowly. Also, what you need in order for a storm to kind of grow and sustain itself is a lack of wind shear. Now, wind shear is winds vertically as we go up in the atmosphere that get stronger with height. When they are stronger, they blow the tops off of developing thunderstorms. And of course, hurricanes start, or tropical systems start, as a cluster of thunderstorms. If they can't grow and mature with height and they get the tops blown off them from high wind shear, the storm won't really grow or sustain itself at all. So what you're seeing here is the forecast wind shear. The bright yellows are indicating areas that are not conducive or not favorable for a storm to develop. High wind shear areas are what you're looking at here. So the area that the storm's sitting right now has some wind shear, but it is forecast to lift north in the Gulf of Mexico that has significantly greater wind shear as we go way out into the forecast term. So despite the warm waters of the Gulf of Mexico, it's going to have to combat and kind of hold itself together despite some strong wind shear. All right, let's talk forecast models now. What you're going to see here are lines that pop up. We call these the spaghetti plots, and each line is a different computer model taking the initial conditions of the atmosphere of the storm, tweaking it just a little bit, and giving its own outcome. So generally right now we're seeing consensus of taking it north. Notice as I talked about the interaction with Yucatan there, if that was to happen, it would significantly weaken, and whatever remains after it heads back over open waters is what we'll have to watch closely as it moves back into an area that's conducive in terms of the warm water, but not so much in terms of the wind shear as it lifts north. Regardless if it gets a name or not, the legacy for this system is going to be the amount of moisture it delivers to the southeastern seaboard, the Gulf of Mexico coastline, and eventually up into the mid-Atlantic. This is a very moist, very wet system, also very, very messy. And as it moves north into the Gulf of Mexico, it is going to have a moisture fetch on its eastern flank that is really going to pump in that tropical-like downpour activity all up and down Florida and eventually over Alabama, Mississippi, Georgia, and the Carolinas, and eventually up into the mid-Atlantic as well as we get into the Memorial Day holiday weekend and beyond. And that'll present itself with some flooding concerns because we just got off from a pattern that was very, very wet like this. Several inches of rain have already fallen, so the ground is very saturated. Here's one of the forecast models, the European indicating rainfall totals from now until next Thursday, or this Thursday. No, that's next Thursday. Next Thursday is what we're looking at here. Notice the yellows and oranges, and that's off the map here. 6+ inches of rain, likely 6 to 12 inches in these areas, all lifting up along the eastern seaboard. So it's going to be a very, very wet pattern, regardless if this gets a name or not. So we'll watch it very closely. Hey, if you're watching on YouTube or on Facebook, make sure you find me on my social media and be social. You have any questions on any of the tropical systems or what's upcoming for the next hurricane season, we can talk about it. Find me on Facebook, meteorologist Tim Pandajis, or on Twitter at 13 Tim Pandajis. We'll have another update if anything changes.